music's greatest songs. Greatest songs. Worth covering. Original classic hitmakers.
And this is a special song with a fantastic story. Fantastic story. We're going back to 1977, I believe, that sort of time. Prime 70s, prime disco. And of course, you had all this wonderful funk and soul coming out of America in the 60s, and then it roared into the 70s and turned into this disco. And I think it was at this point that House would probably step in and say that it was these kind of disco beats that actually then provoked hip-hop. Would you say that was true? It was, wasn't it? It was this kind of disco vibe. Not this one in particular, but there was a lot going on.
Yeah, I think... Yeah, it was a hip hop was a revolution towards
yeah,
that
was,
because in New York, you had New York,
you had
and
the
then you
white
had,
money,
yes,
dancing to disco.
You got
that,
they're dancing with their furries and whatever it is,
yeah.
And then you had an area, Bronx, where it's like a lot of drugs, a lot of corruption, a lot of crime,
yeah.
And it was like in the same state.
Yeah.
So they were like, okay, you know what? We're going to say what we want to say,
our
music. And then
out.
It was like a revolution towards
yeah.
disco. But yeah,
yeah,
disco is still disco, you know? Like,
yeah.
I don't know how relevant disco is right now, though. That's interesting. Like, who does disco now? It's not...
Well, I mean, it was a genre
now.
Thing.
Yeah.
It's totally a genre thing.
Yeah.
But I think that disco turned into pop. I think if you listen to pop, there are so many elements of disco in it.
I didn't want to say that, but there was a big debate about this.
Yeah.
That disco is not pop.
It's not, but I think there's elements. I think it draws.
It's interesting. I mean, look.
The upbeat, the up-tempo.
It is interesting. Yeah.
No, they're not the same thing. No, I wouldn't dare say that. But let's talk about two artists that you probably won't know the names of, but you will know their songs. McFadden and Whitehead. This is how they became known as an American R&B duo. And this is their signature tune, Ain't No Stopping Us Now. And they sang it. They wrote and produced and they sang it. But the thing with these guys is they actually wrote and produced some of the most popular R&B hits of the 70s. That's what they were. They were this writing duo. They were incredible. And they wrote for Gamble and Huff record label. For Philadelphia International Records. Now the story, guys, and we all love the story of it, it's quite interesting. So this song is often talked about in terms of reflecting. I just want to get my, I've got to make sure I get my facts correct here. So it's often talked about representing the African American community, and it attained popularity and then was referred to as the new black national anthem because it talked about, you know, so many things that have held us down, we're not going to accept it anymore, and totally interpreted as a statement from the African American community. Actually, when the guys were interviewed about the song, they turned around and went, not so much. It's actually about Gamble and Huff record label and our big bosses because they held us down. And there were so many songs that these guys wanted to, you know, McFadden and Whitehead wanted to release themselves. And they kept being told, no, let's use the artists that we've already made famous on the label. Why would you want to release something and compete against them? Give them the song. And It got very frustrating for the pair of them because they're performers and singers themselves. So they felt that they were held down. And then on this one, they actually turned around and went, no, we're releasing it. And they did. And it was a huge, huge hit. So these guys also wrote things like Wake Up Everybody. I don't know whether you know that one. I should cover that.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah,
they wrote
incredible
it?
Song. Yeah. It's theirs.
Wake Up Everybody?
Yeah.
That's crazy. If that's the song I have in mind, then this one of my favorite tunes.
Yeah, it's that mellow tune. What's the way?
I think John Legend covered that or sang that. I don't know. But Wake Up Everybody, if that's the record, then yeah, it's one of my favorite.
And I feel like that has a little bit of a political message as well. And that.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's
political.
Going on. Yeah. The More I Get, The More I Want. Cold, Cold World. Teddy Pendergrass got that one. Just got to be careful. I mean, remember that we're going back a lot of years, and through the late 60s they were writing these. So when they finally went, nah, we're gonna do this one ourselves in 1977, it was 79 actually when this song finally came out, and it became a complete dance floor anthem. And they did an album of the same name. It was number one on the R&B charts, number 13 on the pop charts. So they did both. They sold 8 million records worldwide, which again, as someone walking into a shop and buying a vinyl, nominated for a Grammy Award. And there's two more versions of the song. They were released back in 1981. And so, it really really put them on the map. And one of the wonderful things they did was they featured it on the Oprah Winfrey Show, apparently, where they sang their most famous song. Oprah absolutely loved it. La la la. But I've got a list here of all these amazing songs. They wrote for the Jacksons. They wrote for Gloria Gaynor. They wrote for, I'm just looking at all the names, Harold Melvin and the Blue Notes. Hilarious. Going really, really far back. But I find it interesting that, you know, these guys really quite, you get this huge sense of frustration when I was trying to research this song. Huge sense of frustration from them because they were told that this song should go to the OJs. And they turned around and went, yeah, that's not happening. We're doing this one. So shut up. And off they did. Released as the lead single and massive all over the world. I'm now going to play it in its full.
If you liked this episode of Yalla Home, drop a like and subscribe. 95. Be sure to follow us on Instagram for all our daily updates and top stories.